I welcome all of you on platform of Your PD Education, and you are watching the series of Fundo 15 questions, in which we have further divided into three categories as per the difficulty level. You know, Fodu and Khichdi and Halwa, just mockery terms we have taken. So this series, actually Fundo series, is nothing but every lecture, in every lecture you are going to learn some concepts, some fundas, which I am very sure you have not done so far. And purpose is not to teach you something which you have not done so far, or to teach you something ticklish, but the purpose is to teach you something from where this year question may come in exam and will come in the exam. So this particular lecture is related to XE paper of GATE, and topic or the subject is fluid mechanics. You know, in XE, the kind of questions which are asked is little different from the other branches, like fluid mechanics is there in mechanical engineering also and civil engineering also. But the kind of question you can expect in XE are different from civil engineering and mechanical engineering papers. So those of you who are dedicatedly preparing for XE for some purpose, to hit high GATE score and get into easily into some of the courses like NITI or DOMS or IEOR or many other courses like that into IITs and get good placement. So if purpose is that, smart strategy you have made, then this fluid mechanics can really give you very good score. You know, I think 30 out of 30 you can hit, if I'm not wrong, 30 marks are there, 30 marks you can get from this paper or something. So that score you can hit in fluid mechanics. Pretty simple paper it comes, but yes, there are some ticklish question, and this Fundo series covers that only. So let's go now, and let's start. We are watching the selection module of Your PD, and let me start with the syllabus of this particular paper XE. So see, they mentioned this syllabus. Syllabus gives us some idea. We are very sure in XE, if you read line by line, line word by word, some questions are going to come from there. So all we have to do is we have to just keep syllabus with us. Like they mentioned, viscosity, relation between stress and strain rate for Newtonian fluids, incompressible, compressible flow, something like that. Then question might come from there. But you know, question can come from little away also. Like they mentioned about Newtonian fluids, but non-Newtonian fluid relation can also be asked somewhere. So do not only read line to line syllabus, but make some kind of interpretation. So I will be talking about shear thinning phenomena today in the class, thixotropic materials, shear thinning phenomena, what these terms are, and some relations, you know, some fluid properties like vapor pressure and this continuum concept. So continuum concept, vapor pressure concept, and shear thinning concept, these are the three new concepts which actually from where question is expected in the exam this year. And these new concepts, if you have not done, you must do it for all the exams. So that is what we are going to cover in today's this lecture. So anyhow, let me start directly with the question, and through that we develop our concept. And I am very sure theory you people have already done with Yourpedia in the theory lecture which we have provided you. So go through this and read this question. I want you to read this question. So there is a container of volume 0.5 meter cube, and it is kept at atmospheric pressure. So this is the situation which is given to us. So let me make the diagram here. So there is a container of particular volume which is given to us, and that container is of particular 0.5 meter cube volume is given, and it is at atmospheric pressure, right? So it is kept at atmospheric pressure. So presently pressure is atmospheric pressure. Any idea what is atmospheric pressure? 1 atmospheric pressure is 1.01 into 10 raised to power 5 Pascal, or that is called 1 bar, something roughly like that. And you have to test it for pressure resisting capacity. You know, 78 kg of extra water, 78 kg of extra water is pumped, and 3000 bar of pressure was required. So obviously if you have to pump extra, then you are to pump that water with some extra pressure, and the pressure required is 3000 bar pressure, was required to pump the water. So, you know, this 3000 bar pressure is not extra pressure. This is the pressure which basically the pump is pumping at. What will be the change in volume of the container? So bulk modulus, given that container was able to retain the pressure, so bulk modulus was given as 2000 megapascal. The moment bulk modulus is given to us, we are very clear this question is related to bulk modulus. Very important basically modulus and very important concept on the basis of bulk modulus. This question I am very sure will help you. So pause this video, try to solve this question within 2-3 minutes and give me the answer for that. Now let me go forward. Bulk modulus is nothing but K is equal to minus excess pressure over delta V over V. It can also be written as delta P over delta rho by rho. Remember this formula of bulk modulus. And in this formula, you have to remember two things. Number one, this delta P is excess pressure. You know, there is already 1 bar pressure inside and 3000 bar pressure ke upar aapne liquid ko andar by force you are supplying liquid inside. So what is the excess pressure? 2999 bar. You understand? Atmospheric pressure. So this delta P is nothing but this is the excess pressure. How much pressure you have supplied? Initial pressure was this. Final pressure when you are supplying, so that will be added. So difference of these two will be the excess pressure. Now this is delta V over V. This is delta rho over rho. Now if delta rho becomes zero, the fluid becomes incompressible. It becomes incompressible and K approaches infinity. K approaches infinity. Somebody asks you, what is 1 by K? Answer is 1 by K is called compressibility. 1 by K is called compressibility. If the fluid is incompressible, what is compressibility? Zero. And when will compressibility be zero? When K is infinite. So that means compressibility is equal to 1 by K. If K is infinite, compressibility is coming zero. That is true in this particular case. Hence, 1 by K is the measure of compressibility. So, if he asks you which one of the following gives you measure of compressibility, 1 by K. K is the bulk modulus. So, this is the question which is given to us. Let's solve this question now. Because we were knowing the bulk modulus question is there, so we will write the formula of K. What is the volume of container given? 0.5 meter cube. You know, atmospheric pressure, at atmospheric pressure, what is the mass of the water? Is the density into volume. So what is the density of water? 1000. What is the density of water? 1000 kilogram per meter cube. And what is the volume in which water is kept? 0.5 meter cube. So initially the container was containing water. How much water initially container was containing? M. So that is 500 kg. So if you see the situation here, the container already contains water. How much water container contains? What is the mass of water? Sir, volume of the container into its water ka density. And how much extra mass you have supplied? 78 kg is the extra mass we have supplied. And initial mass of water was this much. Now, what is the relation? Mass is equal to density into volume. Can you take the log on both sides and differentiate? This is a very, very important relation. This one is a very important relation. Change in mass over original mass is equal to change in density over original density plus change in volume over original volume. Now, change in mass is given 78, original mass is given 500. Delta rho by rho, I can calculate from this formula. You know, delta rho by rho, I can calculate because delta P is also given, K is also given. So, delta P is nothing but 3000 minus 1. 1 bar is already there, 3000 bahar se aya. So delta P excess pressure kitna hai? This is excess pressure is this much and bar means 10 to the 5 Pascal. So divided by rho, the density which is divided by K, sorry, K is also given to us. So this is delta rho by rho. Now we delta M over M is also known, delta rho over rho is also known. We can calculate delta V over V. And what we wanted to find out? Delta V. That is a question. I am very sure this question is a new concept you have learned and this is a really good concept. And believe me, this time IIT Kharagpur is going to conduct the exam and the questions has been taken from NPTEL videos or books written by faculties of IIT Kharagpur. So the concept you will build up slowly in that particular direction. Okay, so after this question, let's go to next question. Read this question again. 5 liter of two different fluids are mixed. There are two fluids, capacity 5 liter each. Liter is the measure of what? Sir, liter is the measure of volume. Can you tell me how much is 1 liter? Sir, 1 liter is equal to 10 raised to power minus 3 meter cube. That means what? That means 1 meter cube has 1000 liter. Remember this particular concept. 1 meter cube has 1000 liter in case of water. Specific gravity of both the fluids is given. Any idea what is specific gravity? Sir, density over density of water. What is density of water? 1000. So if I give you specific gravity of the fluid, can you calculate its density? Yes sir, I can multiply it by 1000 and I can calculate its density in kilogram per meter cube. So now we have two fluids, volume of which is given, density of which is given. So mass m1 and m2 can also be calculated. Mass of two fluids can also be calculated. When you mix the two fluids, the collectively fluid total volume I can calculate. When I mix two fluids, I can calculate total volume. In fact, it is given 5 liter, 5 liter is 10 liter. So the fluid, when I mix, then the fluid shrink by 2%. You know, shrink means that is we are talking about the volume. So shrink is that means nothing but volume. So new volume will be 98% of 10 liter, you know. Initial volume was 10 liter. Convert that into meter cube. So new volume is given to us, mass remains constant. So we can find out the new density also. Total mass per unit new volume, new density, and weight also can be calculated because mass is known to us. Let's see whether we can solve it. So what is the volume of each fluid? V1, V2 is 5 liter, 0.005 meter cube. What is the density? We have calculated. What is the total volume? 0.01 meter cube. So what is the final volume? 98% of 0.01. This is the new volume, but the mass remains same. And what is the total mass now? Total mass is density into volume for each fluid. Density is known, volume is known. So we can find out the mass also. This becomes the mass of total fluid. Total volume is there, total mass is there. We can find out the density, new density also. And if we know the mass of the fluid, we can find out weight also. Can you tell me from which concept this question is asked? From which concept? Answer is common sense. And you will find the questions of common sense also in the exam. So if you are preparing for GATE kind of exam, these are the typical questions which can be asked from you. So how, what you have to do? You have to be very strong in basic concepts and you have to be good in solving questions. So when you are watching my videos or my mentor's videos where numericals are done, stop the particular question, wait there, try to solve it and try to get the accurate answer. And I tell you one more thing, this Fundu series, whatever questions will be done, 1500, 2000 questions in GATE, if you do only these questions, believe me, you will get a really good score and that score will help you to get into really good courses. So 15 to 2000 good questions which we will be doing, please don't miss that. You do that, these are the important questions. After a lot of search, we have taken it. It is similar to the way I told you, HPCL exam is going to come from the same questions. It came from the same question. Similarly, you prepare for this also. Now read this question. This question is related to the concept of ideal fluids. This question is related to ideal fluids. You know, when I say fluid, I talk about liquid and gas. Understand that? When I say fluid, I talk about liquid and gas. This is what I say. Liquid and gas. This is what I say. Right? And when I say now ideal fluid, water and air are supposed to be ideal fluid. Water and air are supposed to be ideal fluid. Now, when we talk about water, what are the conditions it to be ideal fluid? Sir, it should be inviscid. Iska viscosity nahi hona chahiye. Do you know how do you measure the viscosity in liquid? Intermolecular attraction. Do you know how you measure the viscosity in gas? Intermolecular collision. Do you know which gas is called ideal gas? Sir, that gas in which intermolecular distance is huge, so that intermolecular collision is not there. Listen this question carefully. It is interview question also. Is air ideal fluid? Yes. Is water ideal fluid? Yes. What are the conditions? Sir, both should be inviscid. What is the meaning of that? Sir, liquid inviscid means intermolecular attraction nahi hai. Water ke molecule aur dusre molecule mein intermolecular attraction nahi hoga. Theek hai, assumption hai humara. Second, What about air? Intermolecular collision नहीं होगा, वो कैसे possible है? Intermolecular distance is huge, and you know any gas at very low temperature, very low pressure and high temperature will become ideal because intermolecular distance will become huge and intermolecular collision नहीं हो सकता. So yes, ये air भी inviscid आप इसको मान सकते हैं, air को भी inviscid मान सकते हैं. अब दूसरा condition यहाँ पे आता है आपका fluid inviscid, दूसरा आपका condition आता है irrotational. Irrotational. अगर विस्कोसिटी नहीं है तो रोटेशन नहीं हो सकता. इफ देयर इज नो विस्कोसिटी रोटेशन कैन नॉट बी देयर. फॉर्मूला आपने रोटेशन का फ्लूइड मैकेनिक्स में देखा होगा, ओमेगा. अगर आपका विस्कोसिटी ना हो तो रोटेशन नहीं हो सकता बिकॉज विस्कोसिटी इज रिक्वायर्ड. इफ आई हैंग यू इन एयर यू कैन नॉट रोटेट ऑन योर ओन एक्चुअली. व्हाई? बिकॉज यू नीड टू होल्ड समथिंग, समथिंग लाइक दैट. आई एम नॉट टॉकिंग अबाउट ह्यूमन बींग, आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट द मॉलिक्यूल्स. सो you cannot rotate unless until there is attraction from some external source, and viscosity is that attraction. So inviscid is irrotational fluid also. Then comes our third condition is incompressible. Then comes third condition, incompressible, which is not there because air is compressible fluid. Air is compressible fluid. So ideal gas ke case mein incompressibility wala condition true nahi hota. Gases compressible होती हैं, this is incompressible. And last is surface tension, no surface tension, no surface tension. तो अगर तुम ये चार conditions लगा दो, inviscid, incompressible, not irrotational, no. This is inviscid, incompressible and irrotational and no surface tension. तो अगर इन दो को जोड़ दो तुम, तब तुम्हारे पास ideal fluid का concept बनेगा. But remember, fluid is gas and liquid, and जब हमने उसको ideal बोल दिया, तो आइडियल के साथ ये चार टर्म्स हमारी जुड़ी हुई हैं. गैसेस में इनकंप्रेसिबल बिहेवियर नहीं होता. सो रिमेंबर दैट इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट कंसेप्ट. ओके, नाउ दिस विस्कोसिटी के अलग अलग फ्लूइड्स और उनका अलग अलग बिहेवियर इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. सो सी दिस डायग्राम इज वेरी फेमस डायग्राम, ऑल ऑफ यू आई एम श्योर मस्ट हैव डन इट, बट इट इज इंपॉर्टेंट एट द सेम टाइम. सो कैन यू आइडेंटिफाई द फ्लूइड? And I am interested here in one fluid from where I am expecting the question, that is a fundu concept here. So I am expecting for this fluid. Okay, this looks like Newtonian fluid in which tau is proportional to du by dy, and du by dy is called rate of shear strain, strain rate, rate of shear strain or velocity gradient. So this is Newtonian fluid, you know, something like water. And what is the slope of this? Sir, slope of this is coefficient of dynamic viscosity. Very true. अच्छा सही है. अब क्या होगा? अब सर एक बात यहां पे देखो, ये जो ग्राफ है y over x, we know y proportional to x, बिल्कुल सही बात है. y proportional to x square, सही है. y proportional to x under root, right? ये हमने ग्राफ रटे हुए हैं, ये ग्राफ हमने रटे हुए हैं, right? So this graph n is greater than 1, so this A is the graph when n is greater than 1, right? This n is greater than 1, that is the dilatant. Actually these are called dilatant. I will show you the diagram. N less than 1, ye wala graph ho gaya. N is equal to 1, b wala graph ho gaya. N is equal to 1, ye b ho gaya. N greater than 1, ye a ho gaya. And n less than 1, ye aapka c ho gaya. Aur ye bach gaya tumhare paas threshold shear, ye hai. ये थ्रेशहोल्ड शियर है, और ये फिर हमारे पास ऐसा ग्राफ बन गया जैसा हमारे पास n इज इक्वल टू 1 का था. नाउ अब इसको, इस फ्लूइड को हम आइडियल प्लास्टिक फ्लूइड बोलते हैं. आइडियल प्लास्टिक होता है, आइडियल प्लास्टिक क्या होता है? पहले वो सॉलिड की तरह से बिहेव करता है और फिर वो फ्लूइड न्यूटोनियन फ्लूइड की तरह से बिहेव करता है. बिंगम प्लास्टिक भी उसको बोलते हैं. सो दिस इज सॉलिड एंड देन लाइक न्यूटोनियन फ्लूइड, दैट इज कॉल्ड आइडियल प्लास्टिक. So, ये हमारे पास threshold shear, and this is how we have to remember that. अब I want you to remember this. I want you to remember these, right? ये क्या है? Dilatant है, n greater than 1, ठीक है. ये क्या है? Newtonian, n is equal to 1, perfect. ये है pseudoplastic, n less than 1. Ideal Bingham plastic. And what is plastic fluid? ये plastic fluid में ideal plastic, जो plastic fluid है, that is not solid and then typical Newtonian, that is realistic fluid actually. So this is ideal plastic, this is plastic fluid. Ideal plastic and plastic ka kaisa graph banega, दैट इज हाउ यू शुड नो इट एंड आई एम वेरी श्योर यू अंडरस्टूड इट. यहां से एग्जाम में क्वेश्चन आ सकता है. अब सी व्हाट अदर क्वेश्चन आई एक्सपेक्ट इन द न्यूटोनियन फ्लूड. इन द न्यूटोनियन फ्लूड एज आई यू नो लेट से शेक द फ्लूड. मैं उसको शेक करता हूं. फ्लूड पड़ा है कंटेनर में, मैं उसको हिलाता हूं. एक फ्लूड पड़ा है. आई हैव यस लेट मी गिव यू द एग्जांपल. दिस अ बॉटल राइट. दिस अ फ्लूड. मैंने उसको शेक किया ऐसे. तो मैंने क्या किया, टाउ इंट्रोड्यूस किया या डी यू बाई डी वाई इंट्रोड्यूस किया. क्या इंट्रोड्यूस किया मैंने राइट. फर्स्ट डी यू बाई डी वाई मैंने बाहर से फोर्स लगाई. बाहर से फोर्स लगाई तो अंदर डी यू रिलेटिव वेलोसिटी आया. रिलेटिव वेलोसिटी से अगर आपका शीयर स्ट्रेस चेंज ना हो, विस्कोसिटी चेंज ना हो, विस्कोसिटी चेंज ना हो, देन दैट इज कॉल्ड न्यूटोनियन फ्लूड. नाउ थिंक कि मैंने इसको ऐसे ऐसे किया और ये थिन होना स्टार्ट हो गया. ऐसा होता क्या थिन होना स्टार्ट हो जाए. लेट मी थिंक. घर में आपने टोमेटो केचप देखा है, टोमेटो केचप वो खाते हो तुम लोग मैगी के साथ टोमेटो केचप. उसके बॉक्स को लो और उसको हिलाओ, तुम देखोगे थोड़ी देर के बाद वो थिन होना स्टार्ट हो गया. मींस उसका विस्कोसिटी कम हो गया, उसका विस्कोसिटी कम हो गया. इसको बोलते हैं शीयर थिनिंग प्रोसेस. वो नॉन न्यूटोनियन फ्लूड होता है, न्यूटोनियन फ्लूड नहीं होता, नॉन न्यूटोनियन फ्लूड वो होता है. और वो शीयर थिनिंग फिनोमेना आई थिंक दैट दीज आर देर आर कैटेगरीज ऑफ फ्लूड, उसमें ऐसा होता है, वो हम डिस्कस करेंगे. सो अगर तुम्हारा विस्कोसिटी चेंज हो रहा है तो वो नॉन न्यूटोनियन फ्लूड होता है. अभी इसका विस्कोसिटी क्या हो रहा है, इसका विस्कोसिटी कम हो रहा है. सॉरी, तो इसका विस्कोसिटी कम हो रहा है. अगर हमसे को पूछे कि विस्कोसिटी बढ़ेगा या विस्कोसिटी कम होगा, तो इसमें विस्कोसिटी इज डिक्रीजिंग, एज यू सी स्लोप इज डिक्रीजिंग. इसमें विस्कोसिटी इज इंक्रीजिंग एंड इन दिस विस्कोसिटी इज कॉन्स्टेंट. एग्री और नॉट, विस्कोसिटी इज कॉन्स्टेंट. सपोज आई गिव यू नाउ अ फ्लूड फॉलोइंग द रिलेशन टाउ इज इक्वल टू म्यू डी यू बाई डी वाई रेज टू पावर 0.3 रेज टू पावर 0.3 एंड इज लेस देन 1. दिस कम्स इन दिस कैटेगरी. नाउ एज आई शेक द फ्लूड वट विल हैपन टू इस विस्कोसिटी. द विस्कोसिटी विल डिक्रीज. वाई? बिकॉज स्लोप इज गोइंग टू डिक्रीज फॉर दिस पर्टिकुलर फ्लूड. यू अंडरस्टैंड दैट? सो ऐसे एग्जाम में क्वेश्चन कैन बी फ्रेम्ड. आई होप द फंडा यू हैव लर्नड. एंड दिस इज अनदर क्वेश्चन फॉर यू, फॉर योर रेफरेंस. एग्जाम में क्वेश्चन आएगा. आई एम टेलिंग यू रिपीटेडली, फंडू 15 सीरीज इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर एग्जाम. रिवाइज इट वेल सो दैट यू स्कोर रियली हाई इन योर गेट एग्जाम. ओके, आइडियल फ्लूड दे रखा है हमारे पास. आइडियल फ्लूड में शेयर स्ट्रेस क्या होती है? जीरो होती है. अभी तो किया उसको. आइडियल फ्लूड इज दैट फ्लूड इन विच यू नो म्यू इज जीरो इन विसिड. टाउ इज इक्वल टू म्यू डी यू बाई डी वाई. When I say fluid is ideal, what is the meaning of that? Sir, mu is zero. If mu is zero, what is shear stress? That is also zero. So shear stress is zero for ideal fluid. We know that. Acha, Newtonian fluid mein kya hota hai? Ye to kiya. Shear stress varies linearly with the rate of shear strain. Ye bhi to humne kar liya. Acha, Bingham plastic kya hota hai? Bingham plastic. Sir, fluid behaves like solid up to a minimum yield stress threshold value. एंड देन लीनियर रिलेशन. तो ये बिंगम प्लास्टिक होगा, बिल्कुल सही है. नॉन न्यूटोनियन क्या होता है? नॉन न्यूटोनियन सर, नॉन न्यूटोनियन शीयर स्ट्रेस डज नॉट वेरी लीनियरली. शीयर स्ट्रेस डज नॉट वेरी लीनियरली. तो ये आपका नॉन न्यूटोनियन होता है. अब इसको देखो, विस्कोसिटी डिक्रीजेज विद इंक्रीज इन टेम्परेचर. ये अलग फिनोमिना है, ये अलग फिनोमिना है. जो आपका कौन डिस्प्ले करता है? वो डिस्प्ले करता है आपका लिक्विड. In liquid, the viscosity decreases with increase in temperature, and in gases, the viscosity increases with increase in temperature. Remember that. Exam में question आएगा तो यहीं से आएगा. Exam में question कहाँ से सर आएगा? और एक कौन सी viscosity होती है? ये आपकी कौन सी viscosity होती है? ये आपकी viscosity कौन सी होती है सर? ये आपकी ऐसी होती है. ये डायनेमिक विस्कोसिटी, कोफिशिएंट ऑफ डायनेमिक विस्कोसिटी. काइनेमेटिक विस्कोसिटी रिलेटिवली कांस्टेंट. ये लिक्विड के केस में होता है. और गैस के केस में ऐसा होता है. गैस के केस में टेम्परेचर के साथ साथ म्यू बढ़ेगा. सर ये कौन सा रिलेशन है? ये एम्पिरिकल रिलेशन है. अच्छा, इसमें लिक्विड में डायनेमिक विस्कोसिटी टेम्परेचर के साथ डिक्रीज क्यों होता है? बिकॉज इंटरमोलिकुलर अट्रैक्शन कम हो जाता है. इंटरमोलिकुलर अट्रैक्शन कम हो जाता है. इन केस ऑफ लिक्विड्स विस्कोसिटी इज नथिंग बट इंटरमोलिकुलर अट्रैक्शन. इन केस ऑफ गैसेस विस्कोसिटी इज नथिंग बट इंटरमोलिकुलर कोलिजन. एज द टेम्परेचर इंक्रीजेज मीन वेलोसिटी रूट मीन स्क्वायर वेलोसिटी इंक्रीजेज द कोलिजन इंक्रीज एंड हेंस विस्कोसिटी ऑल्सो इंक्रीज. सो आपका इंटरमोलिकुलर कोलिजन इंक्रीजेज. एक क्वेश्चन यहां से आएगा कौन सी विस्कोसिटी डायनेमिक विस्कोसिटी. एक क्वेश्चन आपका यहां से आएगा. रिमेंबर दीज टू थिंग्स हियर. ओके आई थिंक दिस वी डिड. वेपर प्रेशर इज समथिंग विच इज वेरी वेरी गुड कंसेप्ट. वेपर प्रेशर, प्रेशर इंपोज्ड बाय वेपर. वेरी सिंपली टोल्ड इफ आई गिव यू अ कंटेनर एंड कंटेनर हैज वॉटर. इफ आई गिव यू कंटेनर एंड कंटेनर हैज वॉटर. You understand that? What is sigma? Sigma is nothing but surface tension, surface force per unit length, surface energy per unit area. So surface energy is surface tension into area. Now the molecule at the surface, are in the tension state. बहुत tension में रहते हैं. क्यों? उनको बल्क मॉलिक्यूल्स को घेर के रखना है. वो टेंशन में रहते हैं जैसे आप लोग टेंशन में रहते हैं क्योंकि उनको सारे मॉलिक्यूल्स को बल्क मॉलिक्यूल्स को इकट्ठे रखना है. दे आर द हाई टेंशन मॉलिक्यूल. हाई टेंशन मॉलिक्यूल मींस हाई सरफेस एनर्जी मॉलिक्यूल. यू नो इफ सरफेस टेंशन इज देयर एरिया के ऊपर हम रखेंगे सरफेस एनर्जी क्रिएट होता है. सरफेस एनर्जी और टेम्परेचर के फिनोमेना से क्या होता है कुछ मॉलिक्यूल्स लिक्विड से वेपर स्टेट में चले जाते हैं. कुछ मॉलिक्यूल लिक्विड सरफेस को छोड़ के वेपर स्टेट में चले जाते हैं. सो इफ देयर इज अ कंटेनर कंटेनिंग लिक्विड द टॉप सरफेस ऑफ द फ्री सरफेस ऑफ द लिक्विड यू विल फाइंड सम लिक्विड इन द वेपर स्टेट. नाउ द वेपर गेटिंग इनटू लिक्विड स्टेट इज कॉल्ड कंडेंसेशन. लिक्विड गेटिंग इनटू वेपर स्टेट इज कॉल्ड वेपोराइजेशन. नाउ देयर कम्स इक्विलिब्रियम व्हेन वेपोराइजेशन एंड कंडेंसेशन इज इक्वल. There will be presence of some vapors here. There will be presence of some vapors here. And those vapors actually will apply pressure on the surface of this liquid. And that is called vapor pressure. Pressure by the vapors? Very simple. What is vapor pressure? Itna kya soch rahe ho yaar? Pressure by the vapors. Which vapors? Coming from the liquid surface. Why? Because, sir, because of temperature and evaporation. And uske bhi niche chale jao. Aur bhi microscopic mein chale jao. Surface tension. सर्फेस टेंशन. द मॉलिक्यूल्स आर इन टेंशन. एंड जब आप टेंशन में होते हो तो घर में आराम से बैठते हो या चलते फिरते रहते हो. अगर आप टेंशन में हो तो आप घूमते हो बहुत जल्दी 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 चलते हो. यू कीप ऑन वॉकिंग. टेंशन में हो बहुत ज़्यादा तो टेंशन में मॉलिक्यूल विल इवेपोरेट. इवेपोरेट सो हाई सर्फेस एनर्जी एंड इवेपोरेट मेक द वेपर्स देयर एंड अप्लाई वेपर प्रेशर. वेपर प्रेशर इज दैट. हाउ वेपर प्रेशर इज रिलेटेड टू बॉइलिंग. नाउ लिसन दैट केयरफुली. व्हेन आई से देयर इज अ वेपर हेयर and vapor is applying pressure on the surface of liquid, don't you think the vapor is also going to apply pressure upar ki taraf? Because Pascal law says pressure ki ek characteristic hai. Pressure is in the all direction. If I say 1 Pascal hai yahan pe, iski direction batao. So direction is everywhere. So the vapor is not only applying pressure on the surface of liquid, it is applying upward also. Now, what is the logic of that? Upar se atmospheric pressure laga. Atmospheric pressure ka reason kya hai? हाइड्रोस्टैटिक प्रेशर ऑफ द एयर. जो हमारे ऊपर एयर है, हमारे ऊपर जो एयर का एनवेल्प है पूरे का पूरा, उसका जो हाइड्रोस्टैटिक प्रेशर दैट इज एटमॉस्फेरिक प्रेशर. तो एटमॉस्फेरिक प्रेशर नीचे की तरफ और वेपर प्रेशर जब ऊपर की तरफ बैलेंस हो जाएगा तो बॉइलिंग स्टार्ट हो जाएगी. ये दो चीज याद रखना. बॉइलिंग कब स्टार्ट होती है? सर व्हेन वेपर प्रेशर एंड एटमॉस्फेरिक प्रेशर आर बैलेंस्ड इन द लिक्विड तो आपका बॉइलिंग स्टार्ट हो जाता है. तो वो कब होता है? जब बहुत ज्यादा वेपर प्रेशर हो जाएगा. बिकॉज एटमॉस्फेरिक प्रेशर इज 10^5 पास्कल. फॉर दैट आई नीड टू हैव वेरी हाई वेपर प्रेशर एंड फॉर हैविंग वेरी हाई वेपर प्रेशर आई नीड टू इवेपोरेट एंड फॉर इवेपोरेशन आई नीड टू गिव हीट एनर्जी टू द लिक्विड. तो जब कंटेनर को तुम हीट करते हो उसका वेपर प्रेशर बढ़ता है और जब वो वेपर प्रेशर एटमॉस्फेरिक के बराबर हो जाता है बॉइलिंग स्टार्ट हो जाती है लिक्विड के अंदर से. दिस टू कंसेप्ट्स यू रिमेंबर. नाउ कैविटेशन इन द हाइड्रोलिक मशीन इज बिकॉज ऑफ वेपर प्रेशर. बॉइलिंग है वो कैविटेशन. नॉर्मल टेम्परेचर पे बॉइलिंग को बोलते हैं कैविटेशन. यू नो बॉइलिंग इज नॉट रिलेटेड टू टेम्परेचर, इट इज रिलेटेड टू प्रेशर ऑल्सो. यू नो वन थिंग, एज द प्रेशर इंक्रीजेज बॉइलिंग टेम्परेचर इंक्रीजेज, एज द प्रेशर डिक्रीजेज बॉइलिंग टेम्परेचर डिक्रीजेज. प्रेशर कुकर you want to cook something at high temperature. So what you do? You don't cook it in the open container, you cook it in the pressure cooker. Usse kya hoga? As I close the utensil, pressure cooker, pressure inside will increase, pressure will increase, boiling temperature will also increase. Now think reverse of that. As I decrease the pressure, suppose vacuum create kar diya maine, I decrease the pressure. If I decrease the pressure, the boiling starts at the normal temperature, which is called cavitation. I remember now one recent question in the interview was asked in NPCIL. Boiling can start at less temperature also, right? Vacuum pressure, yes. How do you create vacuum? Sir, suction. So, ek kaam karo, ek bottle lo, cold drink ka bottle lo, straw lo, take a straw, take cold drink bottle and do suction. With mouth you can do suction. Will the boiling of cold drink start? This is the interview question. Is the question clear? This was asked in NPCIL. I take cold drink and I take a straw and I do suction. If I do suction, then boiling should start. Will it start or not? Think of it and answer this question. Yes. So, manometric reading is also, there is an error. Why? Because manometer kya karta hai? Manometer aise humara pressure measure karta hai. Ab, agar yahan vapor ban gaye hain, to un vapor ka bhi apna pressure padega. That will create error in the manometric reading. Yes, vapor pressure, do that. Cavitation hota hai, yes, that is done. Dalton's law of partial pressure. Total pressure at particular point will be sum total of partial pressure of all the gases. Now suppose there is vapor also, to Dalton law mein wo bhi add hota hai. To humara tino aa jayega, iske andar tino cheez aa jayega. Answer is all of these. Answer is all of these. Now have you thought of continuum? What is continuum? Any idea about what is continuum? I told you this is an important concept of continuum. Continuum. What do you see here? Line or dot? And now what do you see here? Space. This one is continuum. This one is continuum. And this is not continuum. What is the meaning of that? Sir, when the particles have space in between, it is not continuity. It is not continuous. Continuity means no space in between. Continuum. Liquids are continuum, solid are continuum, gases are not continuum. Why? Gas ke molecules are free. So, there is a gap between one molecule and another molecule. So, there is no continuum. Let's talk about ideal gas. Can you tell me something about ideal gas? Sir, ideal gas is that gas in which there is no intermolecular interaction. One molecule and another molecule is supposed to be at far distance from one another. There is no intermolecular interaction. Intermolecular collision bhi nahi hai, intermolecular attraction bhi nahi hai. There is a huge gap between one molecule and another molecule. Now tell me, out of real gas and ideal gas, out of real gas and ideal gas, which gas displays continuum? Real gas displays continuum. So now let me frame a question. Solid, liquid, real gas, ideal gas. Real gas, ideal gas. Let me frame a question. Tell which of these will not display continuum. Which of these will not display continuum? Sir, solid will display continuum. Why? One molecule is holding another molecule. No gap. Done. Liquid will also display continuum. No trouble. Real gas will also display sort of continuum because molecules are actually close to one another. Compressed gas. Ideal gas will not display continuum. Bahut acha question exam ke liye. Ab dekho. Inme se kaun si statements wrong hain? Continuum can be applied for analysis of ideal gas. No. Always satisfied. And ideal gas kab banti hai? When the ideal gas is formed. Low pressure and high temperature. When the pressure is very low and the temperature is very high, the gas is ideal gas. Why? See, PV is equal to MRT. V is equal to MRT over P. Now suppose I say gas ko huge volume mil gaya. Gas gets huge volume. Molecule gets huge space. Then intermolecular collision will not be there. To get huge volume or space, temperature should be very high, pressure should be very less, and then V will be very high. So high temperature, low pressure, gas becomes ideal and continuum is not maintained. Continuum is not maintained. In the upper atmosphere, can you tell me, the pressure is more or less? Sir, pressure is less. In the upper atmosphere, if pressure is less, gas becomes ideal. Gas becomes ideal, it cannot be maintained. Continuum concept is always satisfied for a system which has a large gap between molecules present in it. No. Continuum concept is not valid if system, yeah, this is correct. Not present likha hai isme. Wo sahi hai. So, ye do B and C are wrong statements. Read this. Isko padh lo sare ko jo maine aapko satsang diya, jo maine aapko samjhaya, wahi cheez hai. आपको ये नोट्स मिल जाएंगे, आपको करने नहीं है. फंडू 15 के 1500-2000 क्वेश्चंस के कंसेप्ट आपको मिल जाएंगे, जहां से एग्जाम में क्वेश्चन आएगा. नथिंग टू वरी अबाउट दिस, बट इसको रोक के पढ़ लो एक बार. ओके, सी दिस. विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग एक्सप्लेन्स द रिलेशन बिटवीन वेपर प्रेशर एंड टेम्परेचर. गैस मारो, गैस मारो, कौन सा ट्रू है, विच वन इज ट्रू. ओके, गैस मत मारो, ये पढ़ो. नो गैस जस्ट कंसेप्ट. देयर इज अ इक्वेशन कॉल्ड क्लॉशियस क्लैपेरॉन इक्वेशन, क्लॉशियस क्लैपेरॉन रिलेशन, व्हिच टेल्स यू अबाउट दिस, व्हिच टेल्स यू अबाउट दिस. अंडरस्टैंड? सो बॉइलिंग पॉइंट रिलेटेड टू वेपर प्रेशर दैट एवरीथिंग आई एक्सप्लेन. वेपर प्रेशर एंड टेम्परेचर का रिलेशन इज गिवन बाई दिस इक्वेशन. सो Clausius Clapeyron relation gives you relation between vapor pressure and temperature, and this is something which is very very important relation. Remember it. Stop your this video and remember this, and all these things which I explained you, just note these also. Boiling of the liquid starts, I told you, when vapor pressure becomes equal to atmospheric pressure, because vapor pressure will support the take care of the atmospheric pressure, and this is important question for ISRO and interview also. What is vapor pressure? Read it. It is equilibrium, evaporation rate, condensation rate equal ho jayega. Which of the following is true or not true related to vapor pressure? When evaporation and condensation equal ho jayega. Done. Molecule in vapor phase collide with walls and liquid. So molecules will collide. That is the pressure. Collision ko hi pressure bolte hain. Evaporation and condensation chali rehti hai surface se. सरफेस पे चली रहती है वो. एज यू इंक्रीज द टेम्परेचर, वेपर प्रेशर विल इंक्रीज, एंड व्हेन वेपर प्रेशर बिकम्स इक्वल टू एटमॉस्फेरिक प्रेशर 10^5 पास्कल, बॉइलिंग विल स्टार्ट. राइट? एंड कैविटेशन कब होता है? जब फ्लूइड फ्लो कर रहा है और प्रेशर वेपर प्रेशर के बराबर हो गया. वेपर प्रेशर इज प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ द फ्लूइड. इज वेपर प्रेशर प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ द फ्लूइड? यस. इज वेपर प्रेशर प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ द फ्लूइड? यस. Vapor pressure is property of the fluid. Vapor pressure is property of the fluid. चलो मैं आपको दो fluid देता हूं, water and mercury. बताओ किसका vapor pressure ज्यादा है? More vapor pressure. Low vapor pressure. Low surface tension. High surface tension. Majority of properties of mercury are related to this. Mercury has high surface tension, high cohesiveness. It does not let its molecule to go out, and it does not let its molecule to even vaporize. Low vapor pressure. Low vapor pressure means when vapor banenge nahi, to vapor pressure kaise banega? Got it? Mercury, high cohesiveness, always keep the molecule in spherical shape, it keeps all its molecules together. High surface tension means high cohesiveness. High cohesion means it will not let its liquid to get vaporized, because cohesiveness is very high, and because vapor will not be formed, vapor pressure bhi nahi aayega. And what about water? Its surface tension is low. Surface tension is low, so vapor will be formed. Cohesiveness is not there. Vapor will be formed. Vapor pressure will be high. Such liquid is called volatile liquid. Such is called volatile. Now, why I want mercury as a low vapor pressure? Because I don't want in manometer it should vaporize. Because vapor pressure leads to error in the manometer. So I don't want error in the manometer, and hence I want such fluid in the manometer which has low vapor pressure. So in the manometer you want high surface tension fluid or low surface tension fluid. high surface tension fluid. क्यों? It should not stick with the walls of manometer. Done. Mercury नहीं stick करता. Cohesion ज्यादा है, adhesion कम है. You want high vapor pressure fluid or low vapor pressure fluid in manometer? Low vapor pressure fluid. क्यों? Sir, I don't want vapor pressure. I don't want vapors to be formed. Low vapor pressure means no vapor will be formed and has very less vapor pressure. So I don't want high vapor pressure fluid. I want low vapor pressure fluid. That is mercury. So low vapor pressure fluid. That is the reason mercury is used in the manometer. That is a question of written also and interview also. Why do you use mercury in manometer? Sir, because its surface tension is high, vapor pressure is low. Done. Why do you use mercury in thermometer? That is also one of the reason. Surface tension is high. Thermometer ke saath, it does not stick. When I jerk it, niche aa jata hai. Stick nahi karta. Ek aur sabse important property thermometer ke liye. Coefficient of thermal expansion. Wo bahut coefficient of thermal expansion uska hai, achha hai, so that it expands. That is the reason it is used there, right? This is how it is to be done. Though it is poisonous. Okay, now let's see. Vapor pressure boiling, cavitation, condensation is not basically related to vapor pressure. Substance with high vapor pressure at normal temperature is called volatile. Bilkul sahi. Liquid having very low vapor pressure can easily undergo cavitation. No. What is cavitation? When during fluid flow, the pressure in the fluid flow becomes equal to vapor pressure. Let me give you the diagram. आपने नोजल में पढ़ा है कैविटेशन कहां पे होता है. एज पर बर्नुली, मिनिमम प्रेशर इन द फ्लूइड फ्लो इज एट द मिनिमम एरिया ऑफ क्रॉस सेक्शन. यू हैव डन बर्नुली. मिनिमम प्रेशर इन द फ्लूइड फ्लो इज एट द पॉइंट वेयर एरिया इज मिनिमम, राइट? सो व्हेन वेलोसिटी इज मैक्सिमम, प्रेशर इज मिनिमम हियर एंड द फ्लूइड इज फ्लोइंग. लेट्स से वाटर इज फ्लोइंग. वाटर एट पर्टिकुलर टेम्परेचर हैज अ वेपर प्रेशर एंड आई टोल्ड यू इट इज अ fluid property. Vapor pressure is a fluid property. It depends upon the, you know, viscosity of the fluid and all. What kind of fluid is this? I told you, mercury has low vapor pressure, water has high vapor pressure. So fluid property hai wo. Ab fluid property hai to iska vapor pressure hoga koi na koi particular temperature pe. It depends upon the temperature also. As you increase temperature, vapor pressure increases. Why? Because more vapors are formed. So at normal temperature, water has a vapor pressure and water is flowing in the nozzle. If the pressure at particular point becomes equal to or less than vapor pressure, the liquid starts vaporizing or boiling, bubbles are formed, and when the bubble will burst, to one cavity ban jati hai. This is cavitation. Now, the liquid which has high vapor pressure, wo cavitation nahi karega. Why? Because agar uska vapor pressure, sorry, vapor, liquid with low vapor pressure agar hai, uska vapor pressure bahut hi kam hai, to wo cavitation nahi karega. Why? Because low pressure may not be attained during fluid flow. Pressure, low pressure may not be attained, and if low pressure is not attained, so cavitation will not start. So the fluid with very low vapor pressure like mercury will not go cavitation, but fluid with high vapor pressure like water will undergo cavitation. So second statement is wrong. Roko apni screen, apna video roko aur isko karna start karo. अभी एक डेटा है. दिस इज द डेटा. देर आर टू काइंड ऑफ फोर्सेज इन द फ्लूड, बॉडी फोर्स एंड सरफेस फोर्स. देर आर टू काइंड ऑफ फोर्सेज इन द फ्लूड. फ्लूड हैज टू काइंड ऑफ फोर्सेज. फ्लूड फोर्सेज याद रखना, यहां से क्वेश्चन आएगा इस बार. फ्लूड फोर्सेज दो टाइप की हैं. एक होती है बॉडी फोर्स, एंड एचपीसीएल में भी क्वेश्चन आया था. एक होता है सरफेस फोर्स, एक होता है सरफेस फोर्स. सरफेस फोर्स भी होती है नॉर्मल फोर्स, और एक होती है शियर फोर्स. शियर फोर्स को ड्रैग फोर्स भी बोलते हैं. ये फॉर्मूला किया ना न्यूटन्स लॉ ऑफ विस्कोसिटी. अगर इसको मैं एरिया ऑफ कॉन्टेक्ट से मल्टीप्लाई कर दूं तो ये ड्रैग फोर्स बन जाएगी, ये ड्रैग फोर्स बन जाएगी. नॉर्मल फोर्स के लिए ये क्वेश्चन दे दिया मैंने आपको. नॉर्मल स्ट्रेस, बॉडी फोर्स, सरफेस फोर्स. यू अंडरस्टैंड, बॉडी फोर्स इज बिकॉज ऑफ द वेट, बल्क. सरफेस फोर्स isotropic in all the direction, mechanical properties are same. Isotropic, isotropic Newtonian fluid ke liye, normal stress ke liye kaun sa relation hai? किसके ऊपर डिपेंड करती हैं, प्रेशर, वेलोसिटी या विस्कोसिटी, किसके ऊपर डिपेंड करता है? तो ज्यादा गैस नहीं मारेंगे हम लोग, आंसर पे चलेंगे, ये आंसर याद कर लो बस। नॉर्मल स्ट्रेस फॉर आइसोट्रोपिक न्यूटोनियन फ्लूइड हैज फॉलोज दिस रिलेशन, इट फॉलोज दिस रिलेशन, प्रेशर, विस्कोसिटी एंड वेलोसिटी ग्रेडियंट। इफ यू टॉक अबाउट शियर स्ट्रेस देन इट डिपेंड्स अपॉन ओनली विस्कोसिटी एंड वेलोसिटी ग्रेडियंट, नॉट ऑन प्रेशर। तो इन द फ्लूइड सरफेस फोर्सेस, नॉर्मल फोर्सेस, शियर फोर्सेस, शियर फोर्सेस फॉलो न्यूटोनियन लॉ एंड शियर स्ट्रेस डिपेंड्स अपॉन विस्कोसिटी एंड वेलोसिटी ग्रेडियंट, बट फॉर नॉर्मल स्ट्रेसेस दैट डिपेंड अपॉन प्रेशर, दैट डिपेंड अपॉन शियर स्ट्रेस, सॉरी विस्कोसिटी, दैट डिपेंड्स अपॉन वेलोसिटी ग्रेडियंट। ये याद रख लेना, एग्जाम में क्वेश्चन यहां से बनेगा, आएगा क्वेश्चन। Which of the following fluid displays time-dependent viscosity phenomena? एक्सी पेपर में विस्कोसिटी टॉपिक है, विस्कोसिटी टाइम के साथ चेंज हो जाती है, किसकी, किसकी विस्कोसिटी टाइम के साथ चेंज होती है, शीयर स्ट्रेन के साथ नहीं, इज नॉट आस्किंग विस्कोसिटी चेंज विद शीयर स्ट्रेस टाइम के साथ। अगर मैं म्यू एंड डी यू डी वाई की बात करूं, सॉरी टाओ एंड डी वाई डी यू की बात करूं, न्यूटोनियन फ्लूड में, इन न्यूटोनियन फ्लूड द विस्कोसिटी डज नॉट चेंज विद टाइम ऑल्सो एंड विद डी यू बाई डी वाई ऑल्सो, बट इन ज़ूटोप्लास्टिक एंड डायलेटेंट विस्कोसिटी चेंजेस विद डी यू बाई डी वाई, स्लोप चेंजेस एज वी डिस्कस्ड, बट इन केस ऑफ थिक्सोट्रॉपिक, थिक्सोट्रॉपिक विस्कोसिटी चेंजेस विद टाइम ऑल्सो। आप एक ग्लास को रख दो थिक्सोट्रॉपिक को डाल के, तो टाइम के साथ चेंज हो जाएगा, इसको याद कर लेना। फ्लूड दो टाइप के हैं, न्यूटोनियन, नॉन न्यूटोनियन, नॉन न्यूटोनियन भी दो टाइप के हैं, टाइम इंडिपेंडेंट, टाइम डिपेंडेंट। ये जितना आपने किया है ये नॉन न्यूटोनियन ये किया है, आपने अभी तक इसको नहीं किया और एग्जाम में ये क्वेश्चन आएगा, टाइम डिपेंडेंट नॉन न्यूटोनियन थिक्सोट्रॉपिक रियोपैक्टिक, थिक्सोट्रॉपिक रियोपैक्टिक। अब रट लो इसको, न्यूटोनियन फ्लूड वाटर, नॉन न्यूटोनियन सर टाइम पे डिपेंड नहीं करता, ज़ूटोप्लास्टिक, विस्कोइलास्टिक, डायलेटेंट, हमने कर लिया, डन। टाइम पे भी डिपेंड करता है थिक्सोट्रॉपिक रियोपैक्टिक। फंडू 15 सीरीज देख रहे हो आप, हर स्लाइड पे फंडा है, हर स्लाइड पे इंपॉर्टेंट फंडा है, फंडू 15 इसीलिए बोला है इसको। विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग फ्लूइड डिस्प्ले शियर थिनिंग प्रॉपर्टी, थिक्सोट्रॉपिक, शियर थिनिंग उसी को बोलते हैं। अब इसको पढ़ लो, सम नॉन न्यूटोनियन ज़ूटोप्लास्टिक फ्लूइड शो टाइम डिपेंडेंट चेंज इन विस्कोसिटी, with the time their viscosity will change, longer the fluid undergoes shear stress longer its viscosity will become, lower its viscosity will become, that is called shear thinning property। मैं सारा explain कर चुका हूं, इसको आप एक बार go through कर लो। gel के example उसने दिए हैं, उसने आपको कुछ और fluid के भी example दिए हैं, ketchup का example दिया है, many gels and ketchups etc are thixotropic materials and they are stable when they are at rest but becomes increasingly fluid when agitated, तो उनमें variation time के साथ भी आता है, agitation के साथ भी आता है। Okay, so we have come to an end of this beautiful session, so I think this was the fundo 15, I don't know, I think I've done more than 15 question, so XE fluid mechanics, if you want to hit really good score more than 800, 900 and get into really good course with less effort, do it, smart work, and we can really get really good score in this. Hope you got benefited. Watch the lecture again, take the notes, revise it. Thank you.